Hey everybody, my name is Emily and I'm with the Toronto Region Conservation Authority. And today I'm coming to you from one of our most exciting restoration spaces that we have and that we're working on across the GTA. I'm coming to you today from the Meadoway. We're pretty proud of the Meadoway at the TRCA, and so our staff, my colleagues, have been on for the last few weeks talking about this amazing place and how we're getting it ready and how we're building it. But for those of you who may have missed some of the videos or maybe joining us for the first time, the Meadoway is a restoration project that we're undertaking in a hydro corridor. You can see the hydro lines here and the hydro towers here. And this is the Gatineau Hydro Corridor, which is a pretty long one in Toronto. It stretches all the way from the Don Valley, so right downtown, to Rouge Park. And that is 16 kilometers of hydro corridor. Now, before TRCA kind of got involved in the Gatineau Hydro Corridor and started restoring it, a lot of what it looked like was this. Grass. Maybe you've seen hydro corridors before yourself that look a little bit like that, just kind of like a mowed lawn under the hydro corridor. So we and our partners, the TRCA, got together and thought that we could probably improve on that situation. And so what we've done in this section of the Meadoway and eventually along the entire 16 kilometers of it is build a wildflower meadow. You can see a lot of the plants are just starting to come up. Not a lot of them are in flower yet, but they will be really soon. And there's already, you can hear some of the birds around me. There's a lot of things living here already. One other feature that I just want to point out really quickly before we move on is another part of the Meadoway we're building, besides the plants and besides the habitat. And that's behind me right here. It's a trail. This part of the trail already looks pretty good, but eventually all 16 kilometers of the Meadoway are going to be connected by a trail just like this. So you can visit it easily and you can bike on it or, run on it or walk on it, use it however makes sense for you. It's good that we're talking about visiting the Meadoway right now because that kind of brings me to our next piece, which is some health and safety. So we at the TRCA are even in a time of COVID, most recently working on the Meadoway, and we're out there restoring the site and helping to make it better. But we're trying to do that as safely as possible, both for the sake of our own staff, but also for the sake of the public as well. So if you do have a chance to get out to the Meadoway, you may see us working near a sign that looks like this. Oh, I'm gonna try and get it in the camera view here. So, just some things to keep in mind on this sign. It's really important to keep your distance from our staff. We're here to answer your questions and we love talking to people. But basically what this sign just says is make sure that you don't get too close to us. We don't want to get too close to you. We're happy to be approached and explain to you what we're doing if we see you out there. But just make sure that you keep a healthy distance and just know that if you do see staff out in the Meadoway, they've taken all of the precautions that they can to make sure that they're healthy and to make sure that they're not a risk to themselves, their co-workers, or the community at large. So, wanted to definitely stress that in this time because it's so important. But let's talk about the Meadoway again. Okay, so when we think about a restoration project that looks a little bit like this, we often think about the plants because they're really, really important. And when we think about the plants, we think about all the amazing work that they do for wildlife. We think about how plants provide flowers that provide pollen or nectar for, all sorts of critters like bees and butterflies. We think about how, a lot of these plants produce seeds that feed birds, and maybe these grasses provide nesting material, all sorts of amazing things. But what we often forget about is that when we look at plants like this, we're not seeing half the plant. There's a whole other part of a plant that's underground. And with the native plants that are here in this Meadoway space, those native plant roots are incredibly deep and do amazing work for our ecosystems, for this ecosystem and for the community around the Meadoway too. So I'm gonna show you one of these plants, and we'll just kind of go over quickly some of the above ground features that are so cool about these plants, just so that you can see them. One of the plants that happens to be really close by to me right now is a cup plant. Look at this plant. It's really, really amazing. Look how big the stems are on this plant. Isn't that cool? And this is a really cool feature. The stems are a really cool feature. Specifically, hopefully you can see this, where these leaves kind of grasp the stem, you can see that they make kind of a bowl around the stem itself. And that's why this is called a cup plant. It's because these little bowls actually collect water, which is really cool. And when they collect water, what that means is that there's water sitting in a bowl in a plant available for maybe a thirsty bee or butterfly to drink, or even birds sometimes as well. So that's one example of how this cool plant provides an amazing home and habitat. In a couple of weeks, this beautiful cup plant will be much taller. It's also going to have bright yellow flowers. It's so pretty. And so it will produce seeds and pollen and nectar and all sorts of good stuff in addition to the feature I just pointed out to you. Another really important thing about the cup plant has to do with its material that it leaves over the winter. So this is a perennial plant, the cup plant. And a perennial plant just means that although the above ground parts of the plant may die off every winter time, they'll grow back from a healthy root system that's underground. Also really key as we talk about underground plants. And even though the above ground parts of the plant die off in the winter, they leave behind, their pieces of themselves. So this is part of last year's growth of the cup plant that I just found on the ground. This is, not a living part of this plant anymore, but it had a really important purpose, even over the winter time probably, and a lot of these different plant species do. And that's because it has this really kind of woody, pithy stem, and creatures like bees and other insects will often overwinter inside these stems. So even though the plant is no longer kind of living in green in the winter, it's still doing really important work as habitat all year long. Pretty amazing, actually. And that's why we actually don't recommend that you clean out your garden yourself until things get really, really warm, because you don't want to clear out all of the amazing bees and other insects that were overwintering in your yard, in your plants, either. So we've talked a little bit about the above ground parts of the plant, all the cool work they do, but let's bring our attention to the amazing root systems of native plants. Now, if you do happen to come to the Meadoway, you will find signs like this throughout the entire hydro corridor. And these are really, really key because they show you the part of the Meadoway below ground that it's really easy to miss. And so you can see here, this shows kind of the above ground parts of plants. We can see this cup plant here that I've just talked about and showed you in real life. And you can see that the cup plant has incredibly deep roots, even longer than the cup plant above ground is tall. You can also see, and so there's all sorts of other native plants that you can find in the Meadoway too. They all have deep root systems. But let's just also look at this one right here on the edge of the sign. That really, really short plant, the really, really short root, that's the turf grass. So that's what the whole Meadoway, right here, would have been made of before. You can see how small those roots are compared to the roots of the plants that are there now. So why does it matter? Deep root systems, great. Well, we know it's good for the plants. We know it makes them drought tolerant, because if there isn't a lot of water and it doesn't rain for a while, they can access water that's really deep down. But it's good for more than just the plants. It's good for the land, and it's good for the entire ecology, entire natural community in this area. The deep root systems of native plants kind of move the soil around. They aerate it, they decompact it, and they create space in the soil as they grow and move earth out of the way. It's really unbelievable. And when they do that, you know, they're creating spaces that things need to live in. So soil microbes and fungi, invertebrates, insects, a lot of these creatures that need to live underground can suddenly access the soil because it's not so compacted. In addition to that, the deep root systems of native plants bring up maybe nutrition, different types of chemicals from deep within the soil column that are important for, you know, the rest of this natural community that they need. And it can bring, the deep root systems will bring up things like nitrogen and phosphorus, all the amazing things that they need. It will live in the body of the plant. Then when that plant dies and it kind of decomposes, then the soil gets those nutrients as well. Really, really important for the entire functioning of the ecosystem. Lastly, and maybe most importantly, although all of these things are pretty important in fairness, is that when these native plants, you know, grow their amazing roots down under the surface, the space that's created allows water to soak right into the ground when it rains. And that's really important because when rainwater is soaked into the ground, that means that it returns to the nearest stream, river, eventually Lake Ontario here, underground, slowly trickling through soil, kind of making its way kind of downhills but underground to the nearest water body, and it gets cleaned in that way, and it's not a danger for erosion or pollution in that sense. Also, when more water can soak right into the soil where it falls, that means that that water won't get kind of pushed to the nearest storm sewer and kind of dumped onto the nearest roadway. It means this whole community is a little bit less prone to flooding. So that's a good thing if you live near a naturalized area. So, you know, these roots, they do incredible work. I'm going to show you a little bit of kind of a game to explain exactly how long these root systems are, because it can be hard to picture. Okay, so I have here a little game that I've made. You can see I've created a kind of scale along this pathway here in chalk, and approximately every foot I have created a marker, and that's to measure the roots of these plants with the demonstration tool that I have for you. I also have these cool boxes. So here is one with a black-eyed Susan on it. I hope you guys can see that well. It's hard for me to tell what you can see. And attached to the picture of this black-eyed Susan is a string. And the string symbolizes the root of this plant. And as long as I can pull this string out from this box, that's how long the root of this plant is. So let's measure this together. Let's measure the string and see how long the root of this plant, the beautiful black-eyed Susan, actually is. The reason I picked black-eyed Susan is, one, it's a really common plant in the Meadoway, and it's just, it's beautiful, and it blooms a long time, so a lot of you may have a chance to see a black-eyed Susan. Another reason that I wanted to showcase this particular plant is because the black-eyed Susan is a really common garden plant. It's a native plant, so it's evolved here, and it has all these amazing benefits, but it'll grow really well in your backyard. So maybe you already have a black-eyed Susan, and this demonstration will help you figure out like what an amazing tool it's being in your yard for you as well. Okay, so let's pull out this root. Okay, so hopefully you guys can see. Okay, we're going over. Oh, we've passed the 1 foot mark, guys. We've passed the 2 foot mark. You can kind of see my shadow too. We've passed the 3 foot mark. Oh, are we going to make it to 4? No, we're not going to make it to 4. So it looks like the roots of an average black-eyed Susan are between 3 and 4 feet long. Cool. Now, we've talked a lot about flowering plants. They're showier, they're beautiful. We love to talk about them. Let's think about grasses too. Because when you look around the Meadoway, and I'm going to show it to you one more time, around half of, well, maybe half, a large part of the area is taken up by grass as well. For example, we have some orchard grass right here. So grasses don't get as much love a lot of the time as flowering plants. Maybe it's because they're less showy. They do flower, but the flowers are less obvious. But they also do this amazing work, especially with their root systems. So I have a picture here of a common grass in the Meadoway, but also maybe in your yard. This is a little blue stem. And same, the string underneath just kind of symbolizes how long the root of this is. So let's check it out. Okay, let's measure. So we're at 1 foot. Do you guys think it's going to be longer or less long than the black-eyed Susan? Let's see. We're at 3 feet. Oh my gosh, we're at 4 feet. Oh, we're somewhere between 4 and 5 feet long. So you can see our native grasses have even more impressive and long root systems than some of our other native flowering plants. And they do such amazing work, despite the fact that they're kind of overlooked. So I hope that you have a bit more appreciation for kind of what lies beneath when you're looking at a restored space, thinking about the roots of that space in addition to the above ground plant material. And it just highlights how amazing plants are and all of the amazing work that they do for us and that they do for the creatures that live in a place like the Meadoway. So I'm just going to show you one last shot of the Meadoway, so you can kind of enjoy it, listen to it, kind of take it in. I don't know if you guys could see that there was a barn swallow flying over the Meadoway, catching all of the insects in the air that these plants are feeding. Pretty cool, species at risk. Hopefully you're able to visit the Meadoway yourself at some point, safely, and I hope that you're able to appreciate a plant today, maybe a little bit more. Thank you so much for watching. Bye-bye.